looking for their chance to jump out and attack. Immediately after the concert. So three more songs. And everyone who can possibly stay, I'll have the band members sit over here on this corner so that it's very convenient for them to come up the steps, get their award. We'll have them pose for pictures, and then we'll have them exit to this side. So if you can stay, please stay. Our last selection is entitled The Tempest. Any of you know what a tempest is? You know, I'm not one of those people that is like real into knowing all the words, but being a band director has forced me to look things up. I'm surprised that I didn't look this up the other times that we have performed this. When you Google it, two main things come up. One of them is a Shakespearean play, and the other one is tempest is a violent windstorm. I think most generally we hear that term used in connection with sea, with the sea. I think sailors boast of the stories that it kind of pops up that it's connected to the sea more than we hear it on land. So this next piece, let your minds picture this violent tempest.
Thank you.
Band adjust inward a little bit and let the sixth graders exit the stage, and we'll be right back with our last two pieces. Thank you. I'm going to do something a little out of character for me. Normally, I start a section with the music and then I give it an introduction. But I thought I'd share a little bit of this with you. If you remember, I told you that I had a song that I was hoping to have these guys play with the high school band. And it was just a little bit too much with our hybrid schedule and all the crazy stuff that was going on back in March to make this work. So I didn't give up on it. The kids kind of thought that I'd forgotten about it for a little bit. I kind of went away from it and then came back. And this piece is entitled Yankee Fanfare. And kind of like researching the Tempest, It was really fascinating and interesting to me, and I highly encourage some of you who are kind of into this stuff to go and do some research on this on your own. But Yankee Doodle is like one of the most patriotic songs that most Americans can think of. You know, it's right up there with baseball and apple pie and the Stars and Stripes. But when you do your research on Yankee Fanfare or Yankee Doodle, it really wasn't a very flattering song for Americans. The tune, the melody of Yankee Doodle goes clear back to the medieval time period. And it seemed like that it kind of worked its way all over Europe. So there were lots of different groups that sung different words to the song. And it was always kind of a funny song. Well, when we started having the Revolutionary War, the British didn't like us very much. And some of these things may catch your interest. Yankee, no one really knows where this the Yankee thing came from, when we first started to be called Yanks. They do think that this kind of goes back to a Dutch term, Jan Little. I don't know how that connects to Yankee. I didn't find anything more elaborate on that. But that's the only thing in the articles that I read that connected anything to Yankee. But these other words, they have meaning. And doodle is considered to be someone who is kind of low class, not very smart, a fool. And a dandy was, in the English culture, was someone who was middle class, who tried to dress up and act like he was one of the noblemen. And the macaroni, of course, was the wig that they wore. So they're talking about people who would put on the wig and wear a hat and try to act like a nobleman, but they were really just middle class. So the British brought this over, and they would sing this to insult the troops that they were in combat with over here, our patriots. And this article says that one of the biggest insults that you know got turned against them in history. So it's kind of a fascinating fact, the song that, you know, we just all take for granted. We've sung it, we've heard it, it's been a part of so many things, and it actually was a slam. And I'm really thankful that, you know, our country is full of creative, courageous people who would take this and turn this back on the British so that we could have this wonderful country that we have today. So this piece is entitled Yankee Fanfare, and it is a patriotic fanfare. It's a little challenging to play. It's got some cool little parts for just about everybody in the band. And we're going to play it for you now. I hope you enjoy. I hope it'll get you ready for Memorial Day and 4th of July and all those other patriotic holidays that are forthcoming. Thank you. Our final selection today is a piece entitled Brandon Bay. Anyone know where Brandon Bay is? I didn't either. It is actually the northernmost point of the Dingle Peninsula, and forgive me if I'm not saying that correctly, in Ireland. And if you have ever been to a bay, there's lots of beauty and activity and probably a little bit of romance. And if you listen very carefully in the middle section of this piece, you might even hear something that kind of sounds like it could be part of an Irish folk song. So here is Brandon Bay. Thank you. They deserve every bit of that. You won't believe this, but it wasn't until yesterday that we managed to make it from wherever we started to wherever we ended without a major crash. So we finally got to the place where we figured out. Great piece of music. Let me close the curtain and I'll ask Mrs. Razor to come up and help me get ready to do awards, and I'll let these guys go put their stuff away and come back out here. Give them another big round of applause.